Over the years, lots of people come in and out of these hallways.
Mm-hmm.
And as I realize my brain is slowly turning to mush, I can't remember a lot of them.
No, they're very few.
And I don't think I should be expected to. It's a revolving door around here sometimes. But then some of people come into our lives and remember them.
They make an impression.
They make an impression.
Some good reasons. Some bad reasons. Some ones that have had to be let go suddenly. Some ones that have just stopped showing up. Some that you take to lunch at a fancy restaurant on their way out of town. One of the best buffets you could find in the city. And instead of coming back with exotic meats and cheeses, they return to the table with a plate with a f***ing apple on it. Who goes to a buffet and gets a f***ing apple? Well, that would be the guy sitting in front of us now. One of the best to ever do it.
Yeah, he was an intern here, I guess, 2016-ish.
Oh, was it that long ago?
An apple.
And then for a hot second, he was assistant producer alongside Mike. He had one of the best primal screams ever. It's a great. We send all of our interns mm-hmm. out into the world with a primal scream to let the world know they're coming. This is this gentleman's here. Ladies and gentlemen, Zach Quinn.
Welcome
you may
back,
remember
Zach.
Him, you may not remember him, but he has an interesting story regardless. You were assistant producer here for a hot second, and then you came to us and you were like, hey, thanks for the gig, but I gotta go.
Y'all go F yourselves.
I'm out.
Double guns in the air.
And you left us to go do what?
I went to New York to intern for Jimmy Fallon.
Yes. And now, at the time, we weren't allowed to talk about much about it because it was, for whatever reason, hush hush. Mm. Can we talk about it now a little bit? How was it?
It was fantastic. Like, honestly, I know you want dirt, but there really isn't any.
No, I don't want dirt. I just want, what were your living arrangements? Because it's pricey up there.
Oh, I had a studio apartment with a roommate who was also an intern on the show. And so we just kind of split the rent, and it was a 15-minute walk from 30 Rock.
Nice.
We were over in Murray Hill,
cool.
is a little up there, but, I both worked at Fallon, and then I also worked online for ASU Online doing some TA tutoring work. So I had two jobs kind of to cobble together my living expenses and then like money for food and survival.
And the work atmosphere at, the Tonight Show.
It was pretty intense.
Intense.
They don't suffer fools lightly there. I've heard it is, I don't want to call it a meat grinder, but I heard that if you fall to the back of the pack, you're out pretty quick.
I don't know about for interns, but definitely in those big companies and shows in general, that's kind of the trend, yeah.
And
that's what I've heard.
Do you see a lot of famous people walking around in that building?
Oh, yeah. Even, honestly, if you're a perceptive enough fan, and you're just in the lobby of 30 Rock, you'll notice people. You'd be like, oh, that's an SNL cast member. That's someone coming in. Like, there's entrances to the building, you know, where you see black SUVs pull up and people coming out. And honestly, I'm so desensitized to it now. Like, even going back, it's just...
Oh, you bump into Tom Skerritt once. It's like you've seen him 1,000 times as he grabs his scone. So Mike brings it to our attention that you got something else coming up. We'll get into that, you know, way down the line after the NDAs have expired and, you know, the red dot of a site leaves you.
25 years, yeah.
But what are you doing? What did you just get done doing? Is this still the gig that you have? What are you doing?
Yeah, it's still my day job. I'm down at Disney World in Orlando.
Oh,
wow.
So you went from Fallon to Disney World.
Yeah.
How did that happen?
On a whim. I finished at Fallon. I didn't really have anything lined up. I kind of, some things fell through and washed up a little bit. But then I applied on a whim to the Disney College program.
Oh.
And that's where I am now.
Majoring in Goofy with a minor in
What is
mini
Disney
duck?
College?
No, it's the Disney College program. It's like for college students and recent graduates who get down there and you work in various roles in the park. So I'm in the watercraft department. And I actually drive the boats down there. I'm a boat captain for
Disney.
You're
a shipboat captain at Disney World.
And it's not on a track. It's real. Like, I have my boating license.
Tell me you got a silly-ass pirate outfit on or something. What do you wear doing that? Because you're not dressing the way you do now.
Oh, no. It looks like I'm either going on the Titanic or, like, a general in the Union Army. It's a blue coat hat. I gotta find some pictures for
I'm surprised Rick hasn't dove through
this
the window
kind of
yet.
Boat?
No, but that's the one at Epcot and Hollywood Studios.
So you leave Fallon on a whim, you go down to Disney, you enroll in a program down there, you get your boating license, and you're now driving boats around Disney.
That's true, yeah.
Ah, what's that pay?
This is the greatest life ever.
Yeah, you do have an eclectic existence. You're a Renaissance man.
I'm getting a lot of life experience.
What kind of boat is it?
That's one of them. That's not the one that I drive here. Type in, resort cruiser there.
Ooh, you're on the old resort cruiser.
Yeah. Watch out, Ahab.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Yeah. What? Are you catching a good check for that?
It's all right.
Yeah.
I have, like I said, I have the tutoring stuff on the side.
You pulling that boat sliz? A lot of ladies want to get up in that captain's chair with you.
Well, I'm in a committed relationship, so I can't do that,
yuck.
Justin.
So
I know.
Gross.
Yeah. Lame. No, it's really cool because Disney provides housing and helps us out that way. So I drive the boats and then I live there in Orlando during the day. I work at night mostly.
Now, Zach, let's say you got a catastrophic thought in your head and you just pull that wheel to the left. Does that boat capsize? Is it possible to capsize the boat?
Absolutely. It's a real boat. Like it falls over. It's not like Jungle Cruise. It's not like an attraction where it's on a track where it's kind of on a predetermined path. This is a free-floating
vessel. So had you ever driven a boat before in your life?
Never.
So you show up at Disney, how long are you there?
Well, I was there for 4 months before they even let me behind the wheel. I was paying my dues at, they called it a deckhand beforehand. So I'd tie up the boats. I was the one that you might see jump out of the boat, tie up the boat.
Mm-hmm.
And so prior to that, that's what I was doing. And then in December, I started training to actually drive them. And they have world-class trainers down there. So in 6 days, they taught me how to drive a boat. It was six, eight-hour days.
I still feel like that's a minimal amount of training. There's a bunch of people on that boat.
Oh, I was so nervous.
There's
for the
families
longest time.
That mm-hmm. are that are hoping not to meet Davy Jones Locker with this kid fresh out of school.
Yeah, you got to start somewhere, right?
I guess, but the fact that it's a passenger ship with a ton of people, that if this kid goes rogue and decides to capsize at some bitch.
And you have to go down with the boat.
Did you witness that kid being eaten by the alligator?
Oh, God.
Great question.
Disney?
No, I wasn't there for that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Have you seen any alligators in the water while navigating your boat?
I haven't.
Don't lie to me.
No,
I know they're there.
I haven't. I've been down in the fall, so in all fairness, you know, they're probably hibernating.
Could you leave this job and then join some commercial fleet because of your experience?
What the hell is the end game?
The end game is just waiting around for a real job. Like, I have an interview this week. That's why I'm in
the
area.
Yeah, but most people get, like, jobs at a GameStop or Pudgy's Chicken
Rouge
or some awful place like a Starbucks. You're a damn boat captain in Disney, and you were a paid intern at the Tonight Show.
Yeah.
That's cool,
Zach
man.
Zach Quinn, former assistant producer, former intern.
That's what we do. We crank out greatness here. This kid's not going to settle for a job at Foot Locker.
And we can't even talk about the thing that he's throwing his hat in the ring for next. Which is unbelievable.
I'm terrified for
Your trajectory's unbelievable.
Oh, he's going to be homeless under a bridge in 10 years. Trust
no problem.
Trust me.
Good seeing you, buddy.
We love seeing you guys. Thanks.
There are lots of ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com. The 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android, and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Make sure to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.